How's it going, Eliminators? Today, I'm going to be showing you how to replace a mower deck belt on a Craftsman riding lawnmower. So let's get right into it. So if you'll remember last week's video, I had this Craftsman riding mower in the shop because it had an electrical issue. Once we diagnosed what the issue was, I ended up changing the starter solenoid and the mower starts right up and runs now. So with the parking brake engaged, when I turn the key, the engine turns over now and works as it's supposed to turn the engine over. And then I went ahead and also cleaned and rebuilt the carburetor because it had a leaky needle valve. So this thing runs perfectly fine. My customer was cutting his grass, but unfortunately he ended up just completely smoking out a Kevlar deck belt, which is quite uncommon. However, what happened was one of his rear wheels went into a dip in his backyard where the grass was really long. He forgot about that. And when the tire went into the rut, the deck completely bottomed out to the long grass, which ended up just completely stopping the spindles from moving because the blades attached to the spindle, and this is the result. It was stationary, pulled tight with all the tension on it to the engine pulley that was spinning there, and then that just completely burned out. So I'm gonna be showing you guys how to change that today. So once again, parking brake on, we're going to come up to the deck lever and lower that down so that the deck is in the lowest position and the mower won't move. We're going to be removing the mower deck from the riding lawnmower once we get it disconnected. And to do that, we're going to have to remove a couple spring clips there. So to lay down next to the mower, I like to use one of these patio chair pads. They're great. You guys can see this one's had some wear and tear on it because I use it pretty much every day. Now, before we lay down, I would highly recommend getting yourself a couple pairs of needle nose pliers if you have different kinds. Normally, the straight ones will do, but sometimes the clips that we're going to be removing can be a little difficult. So I like using these 90 degree needle nose pliers because I can grab a hold of the spring clip and then pull straight back. And they work great. And just one by one, we're going to start removing these spring clips. Normally I like to lay them up on top here so that I kind of have an order to things. So I'll start from the front and work our way back. Go ahead and disconnect your bar. Just lay it to the side like that. Now for this top one here at the front, we can just go in and try to pry it out. Just like that. Now here's an interesting tip that maybe not too many people know about. These little tabs here have a flat edge and a rounded edge. The way that they're designed to be installed and removed is simply flipping it like that and pulling it straight out so that when you go ahead to put that in, this top little retaining side, that just slides on nice and easy, and then you rotate them down and they'll never come out because that little rounded edge interfaces with the rounded edge on the bottom of that spring clip. Same thing back here, we can go ahead and just rotate it like that and pull it straight out, nice and simple. Disconnect the sway bar. Now at this point, I just want to note that I do not recommend at this time disconnecting these connections right there. And that's because if your deck isn't touching the ground, when you disconnect this side, you're going to put your deck on an angle, which can make removing the pins on the other side of the mower a little bit harder. So what we're gonna do is just leave this until we get the pins removed on the other side, and then we can disconnect the hangers at the same time. Repeat all the same steps on the other side. And rotating your pins, again, working smart, not hard. Now that we have all of our pins for the deck disconnected, we still have the idler pulley rod that we have to remove. But first, we're going to remove the deck hanger here. So to do this, you guys can see the deck hanger goes to the inside of this. So I'm just gonna give this a little hit, just like that. And then down here, I'll come in behind it, give it a little pull, simple as that. Now, just as a little added note, on this particular Craftsman riding mower, we can see that on the deck height lever, we have six different cutting positions for this mower deck. Now, we've lowered it as far down as it could go. And on this one, it was touching the ground and it was level. However, some of the older style Craftsman riding lawnmowers do not have any numbers here. They just have a little slot that allows the deck to move. And the way you adjust the cutting height is going to be by a big knob right here. So what you would do is depress the button on the lever, push the lever forward, but it only may go to level 5 or 4. And if you want to lower even more, you have to come to the knob and unscrew it. And then you'll see this lever pushing forwards as the deck lowers itself. So To make it easier on yourself, you want to get the mower deck to the ground level position so that when you're removing those hangers, it's nice and easy and you don't have to worry about lifting the deck up to relieve the pressure off of those hangers. So now that we have the deck hanger on the right side of the mower disconnected, I've just rotated it at 90 degrees so that it's easier to see the next spring clip that we're going to be removing. It's right up here. And again, that goes to your blade control lever. So that's connected to that arm right up there. That's what engages your blades. So again, when that lever goes forwards, you know, it pushes all these rods and linkages. So we'll go to this pin here and simply pull that out. We can go ahead and just lower this down, get this out of the way, and just lay that on the top of your deck just like that. Once again, putting all of our clips in order to make it easier for reassembly. And same thing on the left side, we're gonna go ahead and disconnect our hanger, and then we can raise our deck lever, which will raise these hangers out of the way so that we can slide the deck out. And on this model, we can do it on either side because there is no cable. Usually if there was a cable coming down to either side of the mower, you would want to pull the deck out the same side that the cable is routed. So if the cable was coming over here to an idler pulley farther on the right side, you would want to pull it out this way so you could disconnect it easier and then pull the deck out the rest of the way. Because I have more room on the left side of this mower, I'm just going to slide it out from the left side here. You just want to pull it out far enough so that you have enough room to get at both pulleys, because on some mower decks, you're going to have a pulley cover that also acts as a belt keeper. I just want to kind of note the importance of not grabbing the belt and just pulling it out and removing it. And the reason I say that is because you want to know which way your belt routes on your mower deck. Now on this mower deck, it's incredibly simple. We have an engine pulley up here and the mower deck runs around this idler pulley. This spindle goes along the back through these cutouts, which I'll get to in a moment, around that spindle pulley and then around our idler pulley that moves. So when it moves back, it puts tension on the belt, thus engaging it with the spinning engine pulley. This one only has four pulleys. On some decks, they're incredibly complex. They got a lot of pulleys. The bigger the decks you go, you know, the more complex they get sometimes. So I would always recommend taking a picture of it before you remove the belt. Or in some cases, they will have one of these little diagrams here. You can clean that off. And again, that just shows you the way that the belt is supposed to be ran. But as you guys can see, as these units get older, these stickers start to peel off. So if you don't have one of those, then it's always a good idea just to take a picture of it. But sometimes you can get a parts diagram that will show you how the belt is route, and I'll show you how to do that now. Because as soon as we remove this belt, we're obviously going to have to install a new one. So what you would normally do is come down to the back of the mower, and then right here, we're going to see the model number of this Craftsman riding lawnmower. So we have a 944.607020. So I would go to Google and I would type this number in and I would put parts diagram after it or manual. So once you find your manual at the back of it, then you'll have an illustrated parts list, or you might be able to just find a parts breakdown after running the model number into Google. So for instance, we're looking at the deck here, and as you guys can see, it will show you how to route the mower deck belt. We can also see that it's a number 68 on the parts listing. So flipping over, we go to number 68 here, and you'll see that the part number is a Craftsman 144200. Entering that 144200 number into Stenz, it tells us that it's a 1/2 by 88 inch belt. So if you'll remember going back to my belt video, if you have a belt that is an even size, like an 88 inch is, then we can convert that into a Kevlar or an Aramid belt. It's gonna be a lot stronger, it's gonna be heat resistant, and it's gonna last longer, as long as my customer fills in that little hole that he drove into, so that this deck belt won't blow out like the other one did. Because even with Kevlar belts, just like I said in that video, you can still smoke these out if one of your spindles seizes up or, you know, something catastrophic happens, like completely stopping your mower blades due to the deck being buried in long grass. So with that being said, a 1/2 by 88 is going to be a Stenz True Blue 248-088. So we'll go ahead and get this installed. So now that we are familiar with how the belt is route on this mower deck, I'm just going to flip back the rod And then we are going to pull out this old belt here and just unloop it. Again, this one is incredibly simple because there are no belt guards or anything on here. However, we do have this bracket system here so that both idler pulleys are completely closed in from the bottom and the top. And you're going to notice that there are two different holes here that this rod goes into. So on the 42-inch deck, this rod goes into this hole, and on the 38-inch deck, the rod goes into that hole. Now, I just wanted to point out that this mower does, in fact, have a 38-inch deck, yet that rod was hooked up into the 42-inch hole.
So this is later in the video, and I just wanted to take a moment to briefly explain why I chose to simply leave that rod in the 42-inch hole, even though we have a 38-inch deck on this particular mower. And that's because of this threaded rod right here. So basically, the idea of those two holes is that on the 38-inch hole, you're going to get slightly more tension on the deck belt. However, that can be adjusted out using that threaded rod right there on your blade engage lever.
Now, after I changed the starter solenoid and cleaned and rebuilt the carburetor, I fired up this machine and I let it run. And I did not notice the belt turning while the engine was running with the lever for the blades disengaged. And then coming up to the lever, I went ahead and engaged it, and there was the proper amount of tension on the mower deck belt, which leads me to believe that whoever worked on this mower before simply put that rod into the 42-inch hole and then adjusted the linkage there to put the proper amount of tension on this belt. So everything worked perfectly fine. Therefore, I didn't want to have to spend extra time to go ahead and put a rod into another hole and then have to readjust the tension. However, I just wanted to quickly point that out in the event that you are going and maybe removing that top plate, which is called an idler arm stiffener. And basically, it does exactly as the name is. It stiffens the idler arm bracket underneath to keep the pulleys together. So in the event that you have a worn bearing on one of your idler pulleys and you remove that bracket and remove that rod, I just wanted to include this little bit in so that in the event that yours was hooked up in the 38 or the 42-inch hole, that you're mindful of which hole the rod was in so that you can go ahead and reinstall it the same way. Whereas on this particular application, we have a 38-inch deck. The rod was in the 42-inch hole. However, someone before me has pre-adjusted this so that there is the proper amount of slack when the blades are disengaged and there is the proper amount of tension when the blades are engaged. So with that being said, let's get back to the repair. However, we're not going to have to remove anything on that because we're going to take our new belt and go right through here. I absolutely enjoy doing belt changes on these types of decks because, again, no belt covers. You don't have to remove a pulley to get anything in. Everything is kind of very simply designed. So again, we're going to go through the center here, and then we're going to grab an end, and I'm going to loop it up and around this pulley here. Don't worry about getting them into those little grooves. We'll do that after. Then we're going to take this other side here and wrap this up and around as well. So now we pretty much have the start of our belt being routed. But again, we want to make sure that the belt goes into these grooves here because those are cutouts to allow that belt not to get smoked. So if you were to, you know, lay this thing way back here and then you went ahead to engage this and your belt tightened up, you're going to smoke a brand new belt. So you want to make sure that not only when you're doing it here, before we start this machine and just go ahead and engage the lever to put tension on that and start running these blades, we're going to do just a quick little pull test to make sure that when I pull this, the pulleys kind of move just like that and everything is connected, right? So you guys can see that it's spinning freely and nothing's binding up. Don't forget now to rotate your rod to the front with this piece, making sure that it's out that way. And again, before we slide this deck under the machine, you want to make sure that your sway bar is to the proper side. So if you were to flip this up on a set of sawhorses to clean the underside, you want to make sure that it's coming out the same way so that when you get that under there, we can lift that up and hook up the sway bar the same way it was before. So at this point, I'm ready to take this deck and slide it back under the riding lawnmower. We know that both spindles are turning, so it's not an issue of seized up bearings or, you know, something like that that caused the belt to stop. Again, we made sure that those spin freely. The bearings seem to be okay. We can just go ahead and do a quick little wobble test, right? So you're gonna push in and out, you're gonna lift up and down, try to tilt the pulley like this. And if you guys see a lot of play like that, chances are you need to replace your bearings in the spindle. And on this one, these are absolutely solid, so they're good to go. And after you check the bearings on the spindles, go ahead and do it to the idler pulleys as well. Lift up and down. That one you can't hear anything, but listen to this one. Hear that? So this bearing just has a slight amount of play to it. Nothing concerning. After maybe a season or two, I can go ahead and change that out. But for right now, it'll be perfectly fine. Basically, the thing you want to do is just make sure they turn, right? And that one of the idlers isn't seized. So at this point, I'm ready to take the deck and slide it back under our riding lawnmower.
Now, before we get anything connected, you're going to take your deck belt and wrap it around the engine pulley. If it is a little tight, you can either roll the riding lawnmower back, but I have the parking brake engaged. And if the deck is on the ground, you can just take the engine pulley and rotate it, but you want to make sure that you're only rotating it in a clockwise direction. And now that I have the mower deck belt wrapped around the engine pulley, we can go ahead and hook up the deck.
Now, one of the first things that I like to do after connecting the deck belt to the engine pulley is come down here to the sway bar and connect that, because not only is it going to tell you that you're positioned left and right, but it's also going to position you forwards and backwards. If you come down and look at the sway bar there, we can see we're pretty much lined up nicely. Then coming to the flat side of that nub, we're going to put the pin in and then rotate it down to the lower side, and that pin is not coming out. We can go ahead and lower our hangers down. And normally I like to start at the front hangers up here. So going to that flat side, we're going to put the pin in, same thing, rotate that down, and then that pin is not going anywhere. Now on the left side of the mower, to hook up the rear left side hanger, I'm going to have to lift the mower deck up so that I can go ahead and put this on because it's not reaching. Now that is not because the deck is unlevel. The deck is level. And if you wanted to level the deck after you get it hooked up, you simply go to the nut on this threaded rod here. By tightening it up, you will raise the hanger, thus raising the left side of your deck. And by loosening that nut, you will lower the hanger, thus lowering that side of the deck. Then you can take a measuring tape at the front on each side of your mower deck, and you'll kind of get a good idea of how level your deck is. So if the deck is level, why wouldn't that hook up as easy as the other side came off? That's because I have an asphalt floor and there is going to be some high spots, which is going to raise the mower. And because the deck's not hooked up, we are a little bit higher on the mower side than we need to be. So again, I'll just go ahead and lift up on this deck and then I can go ahead and loop the hanger onto the mount there. Now, sometimes your mower will have washers behind these spring clips, other times they won't. That really doesn't matter. What matters is what I'm about to show you right here. You see, we have the rounded side to the rounded side and that comes out incredibly easy. If a stick or something was to hit this, it would pop this right out and then the deck could fall off of the back hanger. So I'm going to go ahead and replace this spring clip with one that has a little more tension on it. I work on mowers every day, so I just get these little Princess Auto Harbor Freight hitch clip assortment packs. I call them spring clips. They got all different sizes and we'll use one that has a little more tension than this one that's been opened up a bit. I'll go ahead and just throw that into the scrap bin and use this one. And right away we can see much better. So I'll hook up our front left track bar and I'll move over to the other side. The last thing we did on this side was disconnected our blade and gauge rod. So you guessed it, and that's the first thing we're going to do. Go ahead and get the pin in there and that's hooked up. And I was coming down to this front hanger, but check this out. That's a little bit loose there. Now that hooks up via a bolt here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and tighten that up. So that's tightened up now. You guys see me use these Milwaukee cordless impacts all the time, and they use an M12 battery. Something that I just recently picked up is one of these Milwaukee M12 work lights here. They got a button here. These things are incredibly bright. So obviously I have some overhead LED and fluorescent work lights, but this Milwaukee light here is going to be my new little mobile inspection light. So I'm going to go ahead and get that front hanger hooked up. We will also get the front track bar hooked up, and then I'll bring you back just to double check on the routing of that belt. So with everything connected here on the right side, I can go ahead and just double check the routing of the belt. We can see that the belt is going through both of those grooves that are cut out at the back there. We could even go as far as just trying to roll this, make sure that nothing's bound up. Everything spins freely and we're good to go. So now that we have everything installed, go ahead and engage your blades, and you just want to feel for the tension on that mower deck belt. You guys can see that it's barely moving, which means this belt is nice and tight. We're going to get a nice tension on that and there will be no slippage issue. So going back to the threaded rod there on the blade engage lever, if you found that you didn't have the proper amount of tension, or maybe you had too much, you can simply make your adjustment there. Obviously, the farther back that that nut is tightened down, the more tension you're going to get, because the farther your idler pulley here is going to be pushed back. And then go ahead and disengage your blades, and then we'll drop back down and make sure that the belt has enough slack on it to allow the engine pulley to turn without turning the belt. So with the lever disengaged, go ahead and rotate your engine's pulley. You just want to look to make sure that the pulley turns but the belt doesn't. That means that we have the proper amount of slack on the belt when the belt is in the disengaged position, meaning that when we fire up this engine, it will not engage with the blades and it won't smoke the belt. So I'll take this thing outside, fire it up, let you hear how it sounds, and then I'll engage and disengage the mower deck, and that'll wrap up today's repair. Well, that's going to wrap up today's video. Like I said, super simple to replace those mower deck belts on those older Craftsman riding lawnmowers. If you guys enjoyed the video, think about leaving me a thumbs up. You know, it really helps me out. You can click here to subscribe and click over here to watch one of my previous videos. I upload every single week, so be sure to stop on by next week, check channel out for new content. And as always, thanks for watching.